Conducting Cultural Studies Research by Cyrus Henry. Cultural studies research focuses on the daily experience, especially on the issues of race, gender, class, and sexuality, and also in terms with the unequal amount of power within society. This particular research has proven how many social and cultural groups have been disregarded throughout history. In recent times, cultural studies have attempted to recover lost voices among ethnic groups such as African American, Native American, Latino, etc. Not also have they attempted to strive to advocate for the LGBTQ community. In this presentation, you will learn the major analytical approaches in cultural studies research, such as textual analysis, audience studies, and political economy studies. Textual analysis. It highlights the close reading and interpretation of cultural messages, including those found in books, movies, and TV programs. Textual analysis became popular in 1974. This is due to Horace Newcomb's TV, The Most Popular Art, became the first serious academic book to analyze television shows. Newcomb examines shows through a deeper meaning by seeing why certain TV programs such as comedies and the westerns became so popular. Newcomb clarified in his studies that popular media lacked artistic traditions and social contexts. Before Newcomb's work, textual analysis generally focused on only important or highly regarded works of art. Audience studies. Cultural studies research that focuses on how people use and interpret cultural content. This is way different from textual analysis because instead of analyzing text, you're analyzing your audience. An example of this would be a researcher studying a group of people who enjoy the same movie. They can examine how has this movie influenced each person, and does this movie relate to anything that is happening in their personal lives. Political economy studies specifically examine interconnections among economic interests, political power, and how the power is used. The increasing concentration of ownership means that the production of media content is being controlled by fewer and fewer organizations, investing those companies with more and more power. Political economy studies work best when combined with textual analysis and audience studies. An example of this would be 2001's Monsters Incorporated. It's a children's story about the evils of capitalism and how it has replaced the communistic workers' paradise. Thanks for watching.